Jesus is real to me. Oh, yes, he gives me the victory. So many people doubt him. I can't live without him. That is why I love him so. He's so real to me. My God, he's real, real. Jesus is real to me. Oh, yes, he gives me the victory. So many people doubt him. I can't live without him. That is why I love him so. He's so real to me. My God, he's real, real. Jesus is real to me. Oh, yes, he gives me the victory. So many people doubt him. I can't live without him. That is why I love him so. He's so real to me. My God, he's real, real. Jesus is real to me. Oh, yes, he gives me the victory. So many people doubt him. I can't live without him. That is why I love him so. He's so real to me. Well, good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. God bless you, Brother Henderson. Thank God for you, praying for you and Sister Lisa. Good morning, Anointed to Praise. Good morning, Deacon and Sister Polk. Good morning, blessings flowing. Good morning, Elder and Sister Dorset. Good morning, Sister Pinckney. Good morning, Sister Pam. God bless you. Good morning, Deacon and Sister Shy. God bless you. Good morning, DJ Forgiven. God bless you. God bless you, Reese Cup. Good morning, Elder Shane Johnson. God bless you. And Sister Jewel, good morning. Good morning. Good morning. God bless you, Pasha. Good morning, Nikki. BJ, God bless you. Good morning. Good morning. God bless you, everybody. Good morning. Hallelujah. Really, God, that's one of my favorites as well. God bless you, Sister Cheek. Good morning to you. 15662. Good morning. Good morning. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Briscoe. God bless you. Good morning, Mother Fears. God bless you, Pastor Fears, your family in the Greater Ecclesia Church. Good morning, Sister Jackson Perry. God bless you. Good morning, Bishop and Lady Alday. God bless you, your family, and all the saints of the Allegheny Diocese. Good morning, Mary. God bless you. Good morning. Good morning, Sister Winters. God bless you. Good morning, Pastor and Lady Williams. God bless you, your family, and all the saints of United Refuge. Good morning, Missionary Brisbane. God bless you. Good morning, Bishop and Mother Joseph. God bless you, your family, and all the saints of Trinidad Tobago. Good morning, Sister Barnwell. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Cheek. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Jackson Perry. God bless you, Brother Terrence and your family. Good morning, Deacon Briggs. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Burnett. God bless you. Good morning, Sister Stimson. God bless you, and Deacon Stimson. Good morning. Good morning, Sister Linda. God bless you. Good morning, Minister and Missionary Dawes. God bless you and your family. Good morning, Carmelita. God bless you and your family. Good morning, Duchess. God bless you, Brother Aaron and your family. Good morning. Good morning, Sister Briscoe. Good morning, Katrina. God bless you. Well, good morning and praise the Lord, everybody, and welcome to the morning prayer with Pastor Reginald Davis. And as always, it's an honor, a privilege, and a pleasure to be able to bring to you a biblical meditation and prayer. For more things have been wrought by prayer than the world will ever know. And every single day we witness the power and the manifestation of God through the function of prayer. We pray and God answers. We pray and God saves. We pray and God delivers. We pray and God heals. We pray and God works miracles, signs, and wonders. And I'm excited, hallelujah, because prayer is working. working in the lives of those who will pray. As always, if you have a prayer request, we want you to share it with us. If you're on Facebook, please place it into the chat, or you can inbox Reginald Davis or inbox Refuge Temple Church. If you're on Instagram, you can place it right there in the chat, or you can direct message Pastor RJD, Pastor RJD. And to everybody that's on the conference call, thank God for our conference call listeners. They are actively engaged praying even before prayer begins. They're the fire starters, hallelujah, of morning prayer. And I thank God for all of them. Everybody that's on YouTube, thank God for you watching and viewing. And anybody can text in your prayer request. And that number is 336-567-5358. Again, the number for prayer requests that you can text in that request is 336-567-5358. You can text in your prayer request. We're adding them to the prayer list. We're adding them, hallelujah, in prayer, and we're praying over them, and we are believing God with you for miracles, signs, and wonders. I want you to join me now in the Word of God. Once again, in the book of Proverbs, and we're moving to Proverbs chapter 15 today, and I want to read verses 1 through 4. Proverbs chapter 15, verses 1 through 4. A soft answer turneth away wrath, but grievous words stir up anger. The tongue of the wise useth knowledge aright, but the mouth of fools poureth out foolishness. The eyes of the Lord are in every place, beholding the evil and the good. A wholesome tongue is a tree of life, but perverseness therein is a breach in the spirit. Perverseness therein is a breach in the spirit. I want to talk to you today from the subject, say it right. Say it right. It is, more specifically, Lord, help me say it right. Lord, help me say it right. You know, as you get older, you discover that the things that your parents, your mother, your father, tried to impart to you, tried to share with you, we're so on target. You know, sometimes when we're young, we don't understand or even value the wisdom of our parents. We think they're being old fashioned. We think they're being extra. We think they're being, that what they're saying doesn't make sense to us. But the older I get, the more I understand the wisdom of the words of my mother. And one of the things she said to me constantly, because I had a fresh mouth, I think that's about the best way to describe it. I was very verbal and sometimes wasn't always discerning in the use of my words. Still working on it, even at my age. I'm still working on saying things the right way. But my mother tried to tell me when I was younger that it's not always what you say, but it's how you say it. It's how you say it. And that there could be lots of truth in your statement. There could be lots of wisdom in your statement. There could be lots of information in your statement. But if you say it the wrong way, if you say it with the wrong spirit, the wrong attitude, invariably, it's not going to go over well, and it's not going to be received. In the communication cycle, there is the sender, there is the receiver, there is the message, and there is the feedback. The sender has the message, and they verbalize it, and they send it to the receiver. And the message is what you're trying to say. And then based upon how the receiver receives the message, the receiver provides a level of feedback. Might be body language, it might be a verbal response, it might be any number of things, but the receiver sends back the feedback of the message. And so how you say it, how you deliver it, how you convey it is vitally important, because some people don't receive the message, not because it wasn't a good message, and not because it didn't make sense, but it was sent the wrong way. It was sent in a way that made it difficult or challenging to receive. And so this simple verse, this simple A clause of verse 1 of chapter 15 is such a vital, hallelujah, piece of information. A soft answer turneth away wrath. If somebody is already angry, if somebody is already agitated, if somebody is already frustrated, your response, your answer, your verbalized, hallelujah, answer can either help the situation or hurt the situation. And how many times have people simply not said the right things the right way? It might have been dead on, target on, but just simply was not said correctly, said in anger, said in attitude, you know. And the Lord had to teach me this, if I could be transparent. When I first went into educational administration, hallelujah, one of the things I didn't really understand initially was that from my position, and I was an assistant principal, from my position, almost everybody I was going to talk to was going to be angry. Angry teachers, angry students, angry parents. And if I came across in less than an ideal fashion, I could exacerbate the conflict. If they were already mad, and then I came across harsh, or I came across with an attitude, or I came across in some form of negativity, it would not make things better. It would make things worse. Hallelujah. And it took me a minute to figure that out. Hallelujah. Initially, I just wanted to say what I wanted to say. And if they gave me attitude, I gave them attitude, and it didn't get better. It got worse. And they went to the principal, or they went downtown to complain. And it wasn't so much about what they were mad about. It was about that little man in that office had an attitude with me. He was fresh talking to me. He was rude to me. And the Lord took me to this scripture to help me, hallelujah, be effective in dealing with angry people. When he said, a soft answer turneth away wrath. And so I found myself, when people were upset and agitated, I started lowering my voice. And the more they talked, the more I lowered my voice, because it's hard to yell at somebody who is whispering to you. You look like a fool. You sound like a fool. This man is talking to you reasonably, and you're raising your voice to him. So I started lowering my voice based upon this scripture. And what I discovered was, as I lowered my voice, they lowered their voice. As I was calm, they began to reflect the calm. I had a woman come in my office, and she said to me from the beginning, I'm not going to be nice. She just declared it. I'm not going to be nice. And you know, I looked at her, I said, well, ma'am, I in this tone, I said, ma'am, hallelujah, I'm not worried about the fact that you said you're not going to be nice, because of two reasons. Number one, we just met. So whatever made you mad, I know it wasn't me. And number two, I believe in a parent's right to advocate for their child. And that diffused the whole situation. And we were able to have a pleasant conversation. We were able to work on the needs of her child, and it ended well. And in fact, as I progressed in my career, my one secretary said, Mr. Davis, when I went lab before you came here, everybody would leave this office puffing and hollering and screaming and jumping on the counter, and they walk out of your office smiling and laughing. And it wasn't because of me. I'm not going to take credit for it. It was because God showed me this scripture, that a soft answer turneth away wrath. Just, you know, they're already mad. You know, they're already on 10. Why are you going to 20? Why are you going to 100? Why don't you calm down? Because if you calm down, everybody else will calm down. He says, and the antithesis is true as well. But grievous words stir up anger. Your words create anger. Your words generate anxiety. Your words add to the tension. So God, give us the wisdom to soften our tone so that others are able, hallelujah, to soften theirs. And then you can get to the problem. If your spouse is angry, if your child is angry, if your parent is angry, you going to them, and this is a carnal concept, but I've heard it among young people. I got to match their energy. So if they give me negative energy, I've got to match their negative energy. What's going to happen is you're going to have an explosion, because if you have too much negative energy flowing, there's going to be an explosion. It's going to end in violence. It's going to end in verbal barrages.
and it's not going to resolve the problem. If you're after resolving the problem, use the wisdom to soften your reply. You can still speak the truth, but you don't have to speak it in such an angry, boisterous, frustrating tone. Soften the tone so that you can get to the problem and resolve the issue. Look at verse 2. The tongue of the wise useth knowledge aright. The tongue of the wise. When you have, hallelujah, wisdom and you speak, you use your knowledge the correct way. You don't use your knowledge to antagonize. You don't use your knowledge to aggravate. You don't use your knowledge to get your digs in. Well, I had to get mine in because they said this to me. No, you're not seeking resolution. If you're after resolution, you're going to use your tongue in wisdom. You're going to use your tongue. And the prayer always is, Lord, help me to say it right. I'm trying to make things right. I'm trying to bring resolution. I'm trying to bring, hallelujah, some form, hallelujah, of agreement. But if I come in with the wrong approach, guess what? Nothing is going to get solved. It's just going to explode out of control. But the mouth of fools poureth out foolishness. If you're foolish, all you can do is give what you got on the inside. And I'm going to say this to you, and I don't mean this to be insulting to anybody, but if you're dealing with some difficult people, all they can give you is what they are. All they can give you is what they have. And sometimes you have to acknowledge the fact that I'm not dealing with somebody that's reasonable. I'm not dealing with somebody that can hear and listen and take instruction. I'm not dealing with somebody that can receive this the right way. Sometimes all they can do is give you the foolishness that is coming out of their mouth. That's all they can give you. That's all they can give you. But look at this, what the Bible says in verse 3. The eyes of the Lord are in every place. And so that's why we have to be careful how we address things. You know, we get behind closed doors and we say anything. Some things that should never be said, some things that should never be articulated. But because we're in private, we think it's okay for me to talk down to somebody, to denigrate somebody, to disrespect somebody in some form or fashion. But remember, the eyes of the Lord are in every place. Hallelujah. The eyes of the Lord are in every place. God is omniscient, which means he has all knowledge. He has full awareness of what's going on. He knows the attitude. He knows the motive. He knows the mind. He knows all of that. And the Bible says, beholding the evil and the good. Beholding the evil and the good. Some of us are good in public, but we're evil in private. But I need to tell you, God sees that. God is aware of that. Even what you do when nobody's looking, even what you do when you think you're in total privacy, even when you think you've covered yourself, I came to warn somebody that God sees it. He sees the conniving. He sees the plotting. He sees the scheming. He sees all of that. And he beholds what? The evil and the good. So not only, Lord, help me to say it right, God, help me to do it right, because you are aware of what I'm doing. And you are aware of what's going on. Verse 4, then I got to close. A wholesome tongue is a tree of life. A wholesome tongue is a tree of life. Hallelujah. Somebody that knows how to say things right. Somebody that knows how to speak correctly. Somebody that knows how to use their words to edify and not to bring down. Hallelujah. That person is a tree of life. That person is affirming. That person is strengthening. That person is giving life to others because what? They have a wholesome tongue. Their tongue is not set on with fire, not with deadly poison. Their tongue is lifted and guided by the power and the presence of the Holy Ghost. You know, You just don't speak in tongues. The Holy Ghost just doesn't make you speak in tongues. He makes you speak your language correctly. Oh God, he makes you speak your native tongue correctly so that what you say is edifying and lifting people and helping people to be what God would have them to be. The last clause of verse 4, but perverseness therein is a breach of in the spirit. When you're perverse in your words, when you're perverse in your activities, when you're perverse in your attitude, guess what? You are breaking or crushing or wounding the spirit. You're destroying somebody's morale. Don't you know your words can either cause somebody to go forward or you can make them quit? Just those words, just those words, just those words can either encourage somebody to go on with Jesus, or your words can cause them to give up on Jesus. Hallelujah. So everybody, let's mind the words and let's pray. Lord, help me say it right. Help me say it correctly. Help me say it so I'm edifying to other people. God bless you, my brothers and sisters. Thank God for each of you, and thank God for the word. Let's go before the Lord in prayer. My gracious God, I love you. I thank you for your goodness, your mercy, your grace, your love and your kindness. Lord, I'm so thankful for last night's rest and grateful that I woke up this morning, God, in my right mind, able to get out of the bed, able to get prepared to join this great cadre of believers, God, from all over the world. Lord, I thank you today, hallelujah, for the morning prayer family. And whether we've come by Facebook or Instagram or the conference call or YouTube, thank you that we are in the prayer room today. And Lord, I'm asking you to flood this prayer room with your presence, your glory, oh God, your fellowship, God, to the end that somebody's life is edified, somebody's life is blessed and strengthened today. Lord, I want miracles to break out of this prayer. Hey, shatamasiataye, oh God, deliverance to come to your people. Lord God, grace and peace to come to somebody that is standing, my God, in the need of a miracle. Lord, stretch out your hand, my God, in the name of Jesus, and bless every name that's on our prayer list today. Every person, wherever they are, my God, I'm asking you to bless them now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God, remember Latasia, remember Jeremiah, remember Kamani, remember Eric today, remember Anaya. Remember, hallelujah, the Treewell family. Remember Nyree Treadwell. Remember Sandra Frazier, Sharice Brown. Remember the Johnson family. Remember Sandra Roselle Jones. Remember Darius Spellman today. God, remember Belinda Lee and family, Francie Harris and family, Amber Winters, my God. Remember Henry Bailey and family. Remember the Fortson family. Remember Greta Elaine Fuller. Remember Yolanda. Remember Tanya, Timothy, Crystal, Kalia today. God, look on Ricky, my God, in the name of Jesus, and stretch out your arm of deliverance. Remember the Brown and Treadwell families. Remember Latasia. Remember Stefan. Remember Bradley today. Remember, my God, Pastor and Lady Chetram. Remember Karina Bailey. God, look on miracle today. My God, deliver in the name of Jesus. Remember Dr. Jennifer McCarroll Johnson. I pray your grace and your power, oh God, to be upon her right now. Remember Irvin. God, send deliverance in the name of Jesus. Remember Mother Barbara Pittman, Deacon Lewis. God, remember Missionary Bradley today. Remember the Mason family. Remember Sister Deborah Walker. Cover her, protect her, keep her in the name of Jesus Christ. Remember, my God, Devonna and Caden. God, hear their prayer, answer their plea in the name of Jesus Christ. Remember the Sawyer family. I pray for Plain Truth Ministries. Lord, remember Sister Crowder and her daughter. Remember Tony today. Remember, my God, Elder Al Blunt and his mother. God, remember Minister Collins. Remember Bible Way number one. God, look on Apostle Sylvester Norwood today. God, remember the ministry team. Remember Minister Dennis Hilliard, Minister Larry Jones. I pray, oh God, hallelujah, for Region 7, for every bishop, every pastor, oh God, every first lady, my God. God, all of the saints and the people of God in the churches there, God, remember them in the name of Jesus. I pray for Jamal and Dakasha. I pray for the Greer family. I pray for Terrence and Manessa. Lord, every name on the prayer list, every name sent by chat, text, messenger, or email, God, send deliverance right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Bind the hand of the enemy that would come to disrupt, to destroy, to bring down. I pray for the church of our Lord Jesus Jesus Christ. I pray for ministries everywhere that represent you. God, help right now. Strengthen and deliver in the name of Jesus. God, save to the utmost, God. Save, 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 God. Deliver the hearts, deliver the minds of people. Destroy yokes, God, and let them be born of the water and of the Spirit. God, remember the backsliders today. Oh, Shiatanana Masiataye. Oh, God, deliver right now in the name of Jesus. And God, look on. Hey, Shianamasataye. Oh, God, everyone that's downcast, everyone that's depressed, everyone that's broken. Oh, God, everyone that's discouraged. And God, deliver them now in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. God, I pray for the sick this morning, everywhere, everywhere, God. Somebody's suffering in their bodies, but I'm believing you now for healing and deliverance. Remember Mother Boyd. Remember Nellie Mitchell. Remember Sister Murray. Lord God, Shirley Townsend today. Remember Keith and Vanessa. Lord, look on Sister Edwards today. Look on Mr. Wellington. Lord God, Miss Dianelle. Look on James Harper, Mabel, Bridget. My God, remember Sister Glenda Bryant. Remember missionary Teresa Holt. Remember missionary Anita Bryant today, God. Remember Deacon Gainey this morning. God, look on Elder John Williams today. Elder Kevin Day. Look on Eric Robertson. God, continue the healing process. Look on Bishop Michael Austin today. Sister Eula Dixon, Lord God, touch and deliver and heal in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. God, I'm praying for Lady Davis. I'm praying for Geneva, for Dariana today. Let your healing virtue, my God, explode upon them. I'm praying for Azaria. I'm praying for Phoenicia Lunsford. I'm praying, my God, for Diana Williams. I'm praying, my God, for Belle's son. I'm praying for Anna today. I'm praying for the Memory Center of Jacksonville, Florida, for Danelle Macon and his mom. I'm praying for Jamekia Watson today, for Miss Dalma, for Adele Talley today, for Heather, my God. I'm praying for Jean Harrell Long, for Kevin, my God, for Chiquita Harderis. God, I'm praying, my God, for Renee's mother this morning. I'm praying for Dolores Payne, lifting up Justin Edwards, Tamika Bellamy, Lord, Mother Reavers, Mother Sharp, Mother Bryant today, Pat Frischen, Dr. Celeste Johnson, Anila Hemphill Person today, Tessa Hamilton's grandson, Christine, Nellie Mitchell, Randolph. I'm praying for Lady Jackie Audi today. I'm praying for Brother Moe. God, every name on the prayer list. Remember Minister Perkins today. Remember Daniel and Xavier. My God, I'm praying for Deacon Adams. I'm praying for Deacon and Mother Wilson, Deacon and Sister Harrison. My God, Brother Phil Solomon today. I'm praying for Elder Toll's mother. I'm praying, my God, for Elder Toll. My God, hallelujah, Elder Dokes today. I'm praying, God, that you remember, my God, hallelujah, Mother Virgie DuBose, Mother Mary Williams, Mother Lloyd, Mother Perry, my God, Mother Meadows. God, look on in the name of Jesus. Oh, my God, hallelujah, in your precious name, missionary Janet Davis, missionary Joyce Domingo, missionary Gail Hardy, missionary Marlene Roseman, missionary Jesse Brisbane. God, remember missionary Hodges today. I pray for Sister Denise McLean. Oh, God, I pray for Mother Elizabeth Wilson, for Brother Carl today, for Deacon James Grant. My God, I'm praying for Philip Grant, Pastor and Lady Winston, Bishop and Mother D. Oh, God, Apostle and Lady Keith today. I'm praying, God, that you remember. Oh, God, hallelujah, Bishop Alfonso Brooks, Bishop Early Dillard, Mother Shirley Clark, Mother Evangeline Jenkins, Lady Andrea Maxwell, Mother Close today, Sister Shakaya Polk, Mother Carol Coleman. God, I'm praying for Bishop Richard Johnson, Bishop Richard Phillips, Bishop Clennell Williams, Bishop Irving Taylor, Bishop Gregory Wilder, Bishop Larry Arnold, Bishop Alvin Palmer, Bishop Brian Williams, Bishop Johnny Davis, Bishop Stephen Harper, Bishop William Jenkins today. Lord, I lift up Mother Viola Johnson, Mother Hardy, Lady J, Lady Williams today, Lady Barbara Vincent, Lady Deborah Carter, Lady Pamela Davenport, Mother Stokes. I pray, my God, for Mother Celestine Peters this morning in the name of Jesus Christ. Remember, my God, Apostle Herbert Edwards, Apostle Leroy Joseph, Apostle Charles Williams, Apostle Sylvester Norwood. God, I pray for Brother Wiggins. I pray for Brother and Mother Sherrod. I pray for Mother Garland, Dr. Hayward, Sister Hayward, Dr. Hayward's mother, Mother Jill and Mother Pride today. Lord, I lift up, hallelujah, oh God, Elder and Mother Dugan, Elder and Mother Murray, Brother and Mother Chambers today, Mother Carter this morning, Mother Moorhead. God, remember Lady Staten. Lord, I pray today for Brother Keith. God, I pray, hallelujah, for Minister Carr. I pray for Elder Tyson. Mason and Elder Smith today. God, I lift up Mother Foster, Henry J., Brother Cliff, in the name of Jesus Christ. God, I pray for Mother Tanaj, Mother Holman, Missionary Simmons today. Remember Cynthia, Catherine, and Duchess. God, remember Marlette. Remember Maurice. Remember Tony. Remember Dennis today. Remember Kimberly and Chris, God. Look on Cynthia right now. Remember, my God, Mother Jackson and Apostle Moultrie today. Lord, I pray, my God, that you go and visit everybody in a hospital, a nursing home, a rehab center. God, even in hospice, my God, you're the healer and you are the great physician. Lord, I pray for the grieving today. People everywhere who have lost loved ones. God, we're praying that you would strengthen them, comfort them, give them your grace and your peace now. God, I'm praying for Elder Tucker. I'm praying for Sister Pam Davis and the family of Sister Jan Tucker. I'm praying for Bishop and Lady Forehand today and their family. Bishop and Mother Jenkins and their family. Hallelujah, Bishop. Oh God, and Lady Michael and the family. I'm praying for Bishop, oh God, and Lady Davenport and their family. I'm praying for Deacon Shannon and the family of Mother Davenport of Connecticut. I'm praying for Sister Cheryl Wilson and her family. I'm praying for Minister Carr and his family. Mother Carr and the family. God, I'm praying for the Rileys today. I'm praying for Lady Cubitt and the Cubitt family. God, I'm praying for Sister, hallelujah, Janelle Rousett and her family. I'm praying, my God, that you remember Lady Chetram today in the loss of her father. I'm praying for the family of Elder Kevin Scott and the family of Bishop, hallelujah, Curry Brown, their church families and their friends. Lord, I'm praying for the families of the victims of Hurricane Debbie. I'm praying for the family of Duane Graham, for Brandon Spencer and his family, for the family of Mr. Larry McCullum, for the family of Zachary Foster, Denia and Nicole, for Georgia Sutton and family. I'm praying for, oh God, my cousin's family. God, remember the family of Reverend Dr. Spencer Davis. Remember Jerry Robertson family, Linda Smith and family, Woodard Pettiford family, the Stokes family. God, remember the Harris family. Remember Yolanda Moore McLean today. Remember Kim and the King and Harris families, the McLean and Bellamy families, the Pugh family, the Brown family, Sister V. Davis and family. Oh God, remember the Bradley family, the Sutton family, the Mosley family. Remember, my God, Rita Porter and family, Missionary Rosa Hicks and family, Shannon Lucas and family, Zach and family. Remember, my God, Rita Dalton and family. Remember Elder Robert Toll and his family today, God. Lord, everybody that's grieving, God, cover them now. Remember, my God, Mother Moya and Mother Walker. Remember Jaleesa, Jackie, Jerry. Remember Takesha. Remember Phoenicia and Whitney and their families. I pray for Lady Maxwell, Charles and Cedric, Mother Close and the family. For Dr. Carter and the family. For Apostle Phil, Shekinah and the family. God, I pray today that you would remember, in the name of Jesus, the Quarles family. Remember Mother Grant and the family. Mother Harrell and the family, God. Remember the Groover family, the Kramer family, the Hargrove family, the Blunt family, the Bynums, the Taylors, the Lloyds, the Carters, the Giles family. God, remember the Meadows family, the Moyer family, the Perkins family. Remember the Dockery family, Sister Pam, her mom and her sisters today. God, remember, in the name of Jesus, the White family. Remember Anita and the Brian Hopkins family, Margie and the McLean, Melvin and Street families. God, remember, in the name of Jesus, the Ransom family, the Jackson family, the Newkirk family, the Ned family, the Green family, the Nunn family, the Umstead family. Remember Brenda and the Alan McNeely family, Sean and Monique and the Gary Porter family, Trill and Ryan and the Alan Williams family, Tommy and Michelle and the Clark family, the Mays, the Dunlaps, the Purdy's, the Sneeds, the Washington Fields family, the Winninghams, the Bankses, the Taylors. My God, remember the Phillips today. Remember the Middletons, my God. Remember the Felix family, the Zapata family, the Mannings, the Booldums, the Gleans, the Arthurs, the Matherins, the Briggs family. God, I pray for the Middletons today. I pray that you remember the Davises, the Allens, the Caldwells, the Hayeses, the Moores, the Austins, the Harbisons, the Adams, and the Austin family. Every grieving widow, every grieving widower, every child, parent, sibling, loved one, God, remember them today. I pray for the body of Christ today. Oh God, every apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastor, and teacher, every bishop and elder, every first lady, all the pastor's children, mothers and missionaries, ministers and deacons, God, remember them right now. Remember the young people of the church, God. Remember musicians, singers, and psalmists. God, the entire body of Christ today. God, remember them now in the mighty name of the Lord Jesus Christ. I pray, God, that you would strengthen the church. Let the church speak the truth in love. Let the church, oh God, learn how to say things right and do things right in the name of Jesus Christ. I pray, my God, for first responders. responders, essential workers, firemen, policemen, EMTs. I pray today for school employees and students everywhere. God, I lift up in the name of Jesus everybody that works, cover them, protect them, keep them. Everybody that needs a job, my God, make and create an opportunity. Everybody, my God, hallelujah. Oh God, that's on a fixed income, God, make provision. And God, remember the homeless and open a door today. God, I pray today for this troubled world. God, trouble everywhere, trouble all over the globe, trouble in every corner of the globe. But Lord, you remain the balm in Gilead. You remain the great physician. So God, heal the land from sin, heal the land from hatred and jealousy and violence, heal the land from injustice, heal the land from racism and sexism, and let your church be the light of the world, and the salt of the earth. God, we need you today like never before. Help us, keep us, guide us, protect us, God. And as you do all of these things, we give your name the glory, the honor, and the praise. In Jesus' name, amen, amen, amen. Everybody on this line, come on, join me right now in giving God praise. Everybody on this line, come on, join me right now in giving God praise. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. This is my declaration for today. Good reminder, a soft answer turns away wrath. A soft answer turns away wrath. If you're confronted with somebody angry, if you're confronted with somebody that's upset, hallelujah, don't feed into the anger. Diffuse the anger with a soft and godly answer. Say it, hallelujah, not only say the right thing, but say it the right way. Say it in a way that can be received. Say it in a way that can be understood. Say it in a way that can edify and build and not destroy. Say it in a way that brings peace and not confusion. Just ask God to help you to say it right. Hallelujah. No matter who you're talking to, your husband, your wife, your children, hallelujah, your parents, however you need to say it, Lord, help me say it the right way. God bless you, my brothers and sisters. Thank you so much for being with us. I'm trusting that this biblical meditation and prayer has blessed you and that your morning is off to a great start. Look, you can stay connected to Refuge Temple all day today. This prayer service is available on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram. Thank God for those that join us by conference call. Keep coming, keep sharing the number, hallelujah, so others can be a part of the prayer. You can also stay connected through our podcast, Apple Podcasts, SoundCloud, Spotify. All of it's available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Let me thank every single person who sees and sows and shares with this ministry. Your gifts help us to do the things that we need to do. And we thank God for them. And we thank God for you. And if you desire to be a blessing, you can mail a gift to Refuge Temple Church, P.O. Box 3552, Burlington, North Carolina, 27215. That's P.O. Box 3552, Burlington, North Carolina, 27215. You can also give online. Our website is www.refugetemple, N as in North, C as in Carolina.com, refugetemplenc.com, and you can give on the donate page. You can also share through the Givelify app. Just type in Refuge Temple Burlington. You'll see a picture of the church, and you can make your gift there. Or if you have Cash App, our Cash App is $ONE REFUGE, one refuge, and you can make your gift there. And we thank you for your giving, but we thank you most of all for being connected with this morning prayer, because God is blessing people all over the world because we pray together each morning. So please keep coming. Please share the prayer with somebody, and please, hallelujah, keep praying. And as you pray, pray for me, pray for Lady Davis, pray for our children, pray for my father, my sisters, my in-laws, our nieces, our nephews, our entire family. Pray for Refuge Temple that God will continue to bless us. And let's pray one for another that the grace of God might cover and keep us. The Lord help us today to say the right things the right ways. Until next time, this is Pastor Davis. God bless each of you. Shalom. Shalom.